Welcome, everyone.
Yeah, we're going to wait for a few more folks to show up. We appreciate everyone being so prompt and coming to hang out with us, but we've got a few more stragglers coming into the room, so we're going to wait for them, and then we'll get started.
We got a comment that says, louder, please.
Louder. We can project more if we want.
Can everyone hear us?
Yeah, how are we sounding for you all?
We got it. Super, thanks. Thumbs up.
Yay, we like thumbs up. Well, what do you think, Sienna? Should we get started?
Let's do it.
Awesome.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the LA Zoo Presents Animal Drawalongs with Brian Kesinger. I'm your host, Sienna Spencer-Markles from the LA Zoo, and we're so excited to present our very talented friend and artist, Brian Kesinger, who has worked with Disney, Marvel, Lucasfilm, and you may also know him through his own successful Otto and Victoria franchise, as well as many other cool characters and worlds that he's created over the years. This is our first draw along in a series of four as we bring the zoo to you. In this series, we're taking a closer look at four endangered species that the LA Zoo is actively helping to save from extinction. Today, we'll be drawing the California condor, the largest bird in North America and an iconic species in the LA Zoo's mission of saving animals from extinction. These charismatic birds can sometimes be misunderstood. They're often portrayed as villains, but they're actually heroes. The carrion eating vulture is vital to the planet's ecosystems. So the fact that they aren't critically endangered is a major concern. For the past 30 years, the Los Angeles Zoo has led conservation efforts in restoring the California condor population in the wild and saving it from the brink of extinction. Thanks to the zoo's California Condor Recovery Program, we have increased the number of condors in the world from just 22 in the early 1980s to about 500 today and growing. Okay, here we go. Get your paper, get your pens, and your pencils ready. Take it away, Brian.
Thanks so much, Sienna. How are you doing, everyone? Thanks for hanging out with us today. I'm sorry you can't see me. But it's okay. You're going to see the better view anyway. I got my phone here fixed on the paper, and I'm going to walk you through drawing this pretty amazing animal. As far as supplies go, we don't need anything fancy. A pencil will do, paper will do, eraser if you need it, crayons, colored pencils, anything works, even pen. That's the fun thing about sketching. It's not really about the utensil that you use. It's more about the art that you put into it. I am a Southern California native. I've lived here my whole life. And so the zoo has always been very special to me. Growing up, it was one of my favorite field trips we always used to go on. And then as I grew to be a professional artist, it became a great place for me to observe animals. Because one way to become a really good artist is by doing constant observation of the life around you. And I know when I work on animated films, a lot of times when we're creating new characters or alien species of characters, We always look to research what's here on Earth and how that can inform things. That's why I'm very excited to draw the California condor with you today. I'm taking my iPad here so we can look at this picture. Because again, a big part about drawing is observation, right? And that's what's so great about the LA Zoo is it's a place where we can go and observe these animals that don't necessarily live around our home. And so this guy is especially cool. I just want to show you this great photo that was taken by Jamie Pham. And it's something that I'm going to use to kind of guide how I teach you how to draw this animal. And one thing I want you to look at, just looking at this image, and I know there's a little bit of a glare, so I'll try to get around that. Let me move it over here. There you go. So let's just look at the shape of this thing. And what we have here is kind of this nice rectangle shape and a little bit of a triangle. So we're going to page first. Okay, so I'm going to turn on. So you get a lit here. And what I suggest, if you do have a pen, let's start with that. And we're going to start pretty lightly. If you have a pen, that's fine. Because again, when you're learning to draw something, it's not so much about the finished product. It's more what you gain from the experience. So I'm going to go ahead and just start drawing some circles. What this is doing, this is just an exercise to loosen up your hand, right? So again, we're just going to kind of stretch out and our hand loosened up so that we're not too intimidated when we start drawing. Notice that as I'm drawing these circles, I'm moving my whole hand. I'm actually moving my whole arm. And go ahead and follow along and just loosen up, much like you would in before you would exercise, you do some stretching. This is kind of like artist stretching. And this just, again, loosens up your hand to start getting to draw. So we're going here like that. Once you feel like you've loosened up, go ahead, you can change over. Fresh page. I'm going to save some trees and use the same page because, again, this is more about learning so that you can do more finished pieces in the end. So another thing that really helps is looking and learning about the bones and the skulls and skeletons that make up the animals. That's one way to help unlock some of these shapes that's going to help you draw. You look back over here on my screen, I got this great reference of what a California condor skull looks like. And when you look at that, especially compared to the photo, it's a little more enlightening. We're actually seeing kind of a big triangle shape. So what I want you guys to draw right now is a triangle, right? And draw it kind of lightly. And you know what? I'm going to go over here. Draw this triangle kind of like this here. And I'm going to go a little darker just so you can see it. Go ahead and draw that triangle right there. That's pretty easy, right? We all know our shapes. We all know triangles. That's pretty easy. And what you can see is that triangle is really going to give us the basis for the skull. So once we have that in place, next we're going to get this great arched neck that the condor has while you're drawing. So let's look here. So this arch here, the back of the neck. So from the back of the triangle, I want you all to draw kind of a half circle, right? The half circle there, like so. Okay, so does everyone see we've got a triangle here, and we've got a half circle coming off of this shape right here, off the top of your triangle. Great. Now, what we're going to do is from this point of the triangle, right? We've got 3 points to our triangle. From this bottom point, I want you to draw another half circle, but going this way. So it's almost like we cut a circle in half, and we're using one half here and one half here. That makes sense? Let you guys take a look at that and catch up. So already, with just these three shapes, we're getting the attitude and the posture of this pretty amazing creature. I'm a big movie fan, of course, working in movies and that sort of thing. One of the things I love about condors, especially if you look at them, if any of you have seen the movie Dark Crystal, which was a movie that came out in the 80s that Jim Henson had done, he had these creatures in there, and they're very much inspired by vultures and birds of prey. And you can certainly see that in this creature. So that's why it's really important as an artist when you're drawing that you want to really study from nature and learn from around you, because chances are there's much stranger things on this planet than you could even come up with in your mind. And as soon as you start to use places like zoos and other research areas to learn about these amazing animals, it makes you that much better. So now we're going to start to add the little round tip of the beak here. So what I want you to do is on this third point of the triangle here, go ahead again, another half circle, but this one's going to be pretty small, right? And this one's going to be again, just to start to indicate that pointy end, the technical term, right? The pointy end of the beak, which, you know, this animal uses when it's chewing up its meat, right? Tearing the meat off and stuff. So very important to this animal is this sharp beak here. And then what I want you to do is go ahead and take this point here, and we're going to draw a curve back here a little wider, but this is going to go back and be connect to your triangle here, right? So now, again, if we look at this whole thing here, we're starting to see where the head shape is going into a little bit more refined detail here. What we can do now is add another line kind of following your main triangle line here, right? Just add a line here and have it round back into the upper beak. So what we've just drawn is the lower beak of the animal here, which is kind of cool. Now, here's where it starts to get interesting, right? Because right now, we've been using mostly the shape of the skull to dictate what we draw. But we'll see now by observing, going back to the photo, and again, I'm going to turn the lights off. We'll see that we see the hint of the triangle here. I can use my pencil to point. Here and here, but then there's this big kind of muscly pouch area here. That's the skin and the muscle of the animal. And you can see the wrinkles here as well, which is really cool. I mean, these things are pretty amazing. They could, you know, be a little scary looking at first. But once you start to spend time, like, learning how it's put together, and look at those colors too, right? These purples and yellows. Pretty amazing. Must be a Lakers fan. So we're going to go in and add this piece into it to give that little kind of character to the animal itself. So we're going to come back over here and turn the lights on. Like so. And we see that we're going to kind of slice this triangle into three, right? So we have this line here. We have this line here. Go ahead, like, divide it in half. And then go ahead and at the end of the peak, add a third line there. So you should have three sections of your beak. You have the end with the pointy bit, the middle section here, and then the other area here. So what I'd like you to do now is we're going to start to add this jowl, this pouch, to the condor now. And so from this point of your triangle, you're going to want to go through and just add kind of a straight line with maybe a little bit of a curve, but just have it end when it meets your initial half circle there. Like so. Great. And now from this point to about halfway of your middle section, go ahead and draw another curved line connecting those two. Now this drawing is almost going to look a little more architectural than it is natural, and that's okay, because again, we're learning how these animals are put together, and there is an architecture to that, right? There's an evolution to that of how these animals have grown and developed their traits. For instance, why this condor doesn't even have feathers on its head, right? That's a predatory advantage, a scavenger advantage, right? As it's picking through carrion, so that the blood and guts of the animal doesn't get into the feathers, right? So pretty neat to think about almost the storytelling of these animals through history and what they've needed to survive. So now that we have that jowl piece in there, we're going to go and have that connect to the bottom jaw here, like so. And now what we can do is have a little bit more lines coming through here. Little shallow, almost like upside down rainbows coming down through here, like that. And that's going to simulate the folds in the skin. Because it's interesting, again, if you look at the skeleton of the animal I have over here. Over here, you can see that their neck, over here, you can see that their neck is actually very long and fully stretched out. Right. But when they sit and when they rest in their natural spot, there's actually a little more of an S curve to it. So what we're doing in our drawing and what we see in the photo here is that spine is actually snaking through almost like an S, which is really cool. And that's what we have here. And that's why the skin is folding the way it is, because it's compressing. You don't have to draw this. But if we imagine the vertebrae of the spine of this bird, that it's going through like that, as opposed to what we just observed in the skeleton, which was more of a straight line, right? So kind of cool. Let's get to a very important part of this animal, and that's the eye, right? And this should be pretty easy. We're going to go kind of up towards the top of the head, almost, if we divide this in half, almost in the top half. And I just want you to draw a circle right through there. And again, notice how loose I'm being. I'm not drawing a circle like this, right? Because two reasons. It's bad. If you draw like that, it can kind of cramp up your hands, but also it makes the drawing feel a little more sterile. So the looser you can be in this stage, the better. And then go ahead and in the middle of that circle, go ahead and make another smaller circle, and you can color that one in. That'll be its cool little pupil, right? And very important that these eyes are on the side of the head of this animal, which allows it to see more on the horizon and more around itself, so it can be more aware, as opposed to animals like us, where our eyes are on the front of our faces. These birds, predator birds, most birds actually have their eyes on their side of their head so that they can see more. What you can do too, now roughly go ahead and just draw circles. Very similar, you'll see now why Mr. Miyagi had you draw lots of circles at the beginning, was so that if you start to do that here, you start to get all those great wrinkles around the eye of the bird, which is right there. So you got all those there. And then this is really great too. It's such an expressive bird. Look at that little mouth. He looks pretty judgy, doesn't he? So we're going to get some of that in there. And part of that is coming from this muscle that we're getting right here. Muscle, maybe not extra skin, not sure, but man, look at all those wrinkles, right? So let's go ahead and try to get that in our drawing. And we're going to draw this in our middle section here. And it's going to curve up a little. As you can see, almost gives it a little bit of a smile. So if you want a smiling California condor, you can stop right now. Mission success. But if you want a little more judgy one, go ahead and add another little half circle right here to turn that smile upside down like that. And then go ahead and add like a C shape right there. And you start to get this guy who's, you know, a little bit more dour. And that's something that, you know, working on a movie like Zootopia, we would all go and learn from the animals, and the animals would almost dictate what their character would be, right? It's one thing to assign just an arbitrary character to it and do more of, but by really learning what makes the animal special, you can pull out the characteristics from it, which is kind of cool. Important detail that we should get, especially for breathing, is these little nostrils, right? A lot of times you don't see nostrils on a bird because the feathers are covering them. But you can see right above directly, well, maybe a little earlier than where the mouth ends, but we get a little nostril here. So go ahead and just do a little oval right above here. We're almost done, guys. You're doing really good. Do that there. And then the other important thing, again, especially for an animal who needs to be observant of the world around them, is the little ears, which, again, you don't normally see on a bird because of feathers. But we're going to go here and keep it almost on the level of the eye here. Draw a little circle, a little oval over there. So I think what's great now is we have the
general structure, the blueprint of our animal in place. Now what we can do is kind of the fun part, which is adding details, adding lines, picking our favorite lines from our rough drawing. Right now, it's looking a little too much like a stick. This line that I drew is a little longer than what we're looking at, more of the stout bird here, which is fine, because what we can do is from this point here to this point here, we can go and draw a curve here and give even more of a curve to this beak, this prominent beak on the condor here, which is great. Another very interesting detail of the condor is how its beak actually protrudes here. So we're going to want to represent that in our drawing in a little bit by having, again, where we've marked our beak in thirds, starting at this point to this point, go ahead and give like a little jaggy line, almost like a lightning bolt. And that's going to have indicate the beak. And then in the bottom half, from that same point there, go ahead and just drag a line down like that. I think so. And what's cool is if we look back, again, you can see how much even I am still observing the actual animal, even though I've drawn for, you know, a long time, almost 30 years. I'm still always going back and learning and looking at all these cool wrinkles around the mouth. So I'm going to go ahead, and you can do this too. Add just little lines kind of curving up that way and then down this way. Right? So you're starting to see some of the personality and the textures come through here. Pretty great. You can see a little bit of an eyebrow above the eye, that little line there, which again is aiding to its expression. Look at the difference. We have our eye here that's a full wide circle. Now I'm going to give a little bit like of a shallow S like that. And look how much that changes.
We lost Brian for a second. Oh, we're frozen. That'll give everyone a chance to catch up on your drawings if you're not caught up with where Brian's at. Stand by. Right. One of our commenters says it's time to catch up, which is true. Another funny comment said, condor looked like a stork. He said it's called a condor. I think Brian is just, but we can take a minute to ask where everybody is watching from. Shout out for your city. We're here in Los Angeles, obviously. And besides where you're watching, if anyone has any questions for Brian about what he's drawing today. Any specific questions about drawing a bird, drawing a condor? He'd be happy to answer them when he gets back on.
Oh, hello.
He's back.
Hello. Hello.
We have a call from Santa Rosa. Excellent.
Ooh, nice, nice.
Glendale, Westwood, Palmdale, Simi Valley, Burbank.
Yay, Burbank.
Beautiful downtown Burbank.
That's right.
Whittier, Tarzana.
Amazing.
All over Southland.
Yes, yes. Well, you're all welcome. Thank you so much. Sorry for the glitching. You know, it happens. But we're actually almost done here, which is kind of cool. There's one more big shape I want to block in. And then we'll be able to add as many details as you want to add. The I want to block in like a spiky feather boa. Right, that the condor is wearing. So what we're going to do is back on our page. We have this area where we had that big half circle drawn. Right here, I want you to draw a big line coming back down this way. Right, like so, and then kind of. I guess I'd say two spaces over, we want to have another similar. The basic of what would look like a strip of paper, right, going over here. And now I'd like you to draw a line in the middle of those two, right? And what we can have is basically start just drawing from the center line up at the top. Start drawing some spikes. And it doesn't have to be a lot, but kind of mix.
A check. Sorry to interrupt. Does everybody see us and hear us out there in Facebook land? We got a note that says we might be offline. I think we're good.
Great. Cool. Awesome. So yeah, go ahead and random amount of spikes that come off of there. And that'll kind of indicate that great mane of feathers that the California condor has. So now we are at the point where we're all done with the structure of the drawing. So now it's really up to you as the artist to decide what lines are your favorites, which ones are working up, that sort of thing. Things look a little more finished. You can choose to do this with a marker, if you have one, or just use your pencil and go a little darker. I'll show you what that looks like before I bring out my marker and start to do it. But basically, because I've been roughing these lines out, I can go through, and I really love this big arc. I'm going to go through and make that a lot darker. And same with the mouth here. I'm going to darken that up there. Now, if you do have a pen with you, I'm going to do this here, show you how we can go through and kind of pick our lines like so. I'm going to color in that eye nice and black so it's really stark. And I'm going to kind of follow those circles. Now, this, because I am outlining, I'm going to be taking a little more careful with my lines. But all those circles we drew, we can just kind of, you don't even have to trace them all. It's almost like doing dotted lines around them. And look at that big kind of iconic condor I
is sticking out here. Now down here, go ahead. And I love this big piece, the jowls, I like to say, of the condor. Go and bring that up here and have that connect to the bottom of the beak. And then we'll give it a little bit of a line here. And now we can see we're really starting to have this creature, this beautiful, unfortunately endangered animal, come to life on your page.
Hey, Brian, we have a good question here coming from a comment. He wants to know, why are you drawing with a blue pencil?
That's a very good question. It has its roots in old comic book art. Back in the day, when comic artists and illustrators in general were doing roughs with their drawings, they would work in blue pencil, because what blue pencil does is it doesn't Xerox well, it doesn't photocopy well. So when it got to the phase, which I'm doing right now, where I'm inking the drawing with the marker, once I would Xerox this or copy it to be painted, the blue line goes away. So it's kind of a technical thing. Now, that doesn't really apply anymore because scanners and copiers are much more advanced. So for me, it's just kind of an old habit. But I also like how the blue looks against the white. It's contrast and easier on eyes. That's a great question.
Wow. What an answer. Such an insider.
Yeah, right?
Insider tip there. There's another question. Which movie character is your most famous?
Oh, that's a great question. I've been very fortunate to work at Disney for a long time. So there's a lot of famous characters that I got to help work on. I would say one of my favorites is Baymax from Big Hero 6. He was really special because I got to be very early on the production of that movie and help kind of come up with what that character was and who he looked like and that sort of thing. It's a whole team of artists that come together to really design the characters. But another famous one that I've worked on that's probably very famous is Elsa, right? I got to work on Frozen 2 and Frozen Holiday Special as well. So working with Olaf. The first movie I ever worked on, which will come into play with one of our future How to Draw sessions, is Tarzan. And that's where I really got to spend a lot of time at the LA Zoo drawing gorillas. And so we're going to be doing that later on in this series. But yeah, very grateful for the films that I've gotten to work on. So you can see I'm going through, I'm almost done. And again, you can do this for hours. And this is what's going to be, really encourage you guys to post your drawing on social media and tag us in it, tag LA Zoo and at Brian Kesinger so we can see it. Even if it's not this drawing, again, because we're all learning right now. So I understand if you don't necessarily want to share this drawing, but I would love to see the drawings you do inspired by what you learned today. So again, it's not a contest. We're all learning together. We're taking this time of being at home and staying together, staying safe, to learn and grow. So really encourage you to take some time to finish your drawing up, add all those great wrinkles, right? You can add them everywhere. Post those drawings so that we can see them.
That's right, Brian. Yeah, feel free to post your drawings from today's session at LAZU, at Brian Kesinger, tag us. And I just want to give a shout out to people watching from Austin, Texas.
Ooh, Austin.
In New Jersey. Silver Lake, Valley Village, Pasadena, Santa Monica, Palm Desert, Encino, San Gabriel, Orange County, Las Vegas, Nevada.
Wow.
awesome.
So great. Almost done here. The last little detail I encourage you guys to add is some lines coming out under the beak. And that's a good way if you're just doing a line drawing to differentiate the texture between the bone of the beak and the skin of the condor. Someone was asking about what type of pen I'm using right now. It's called a Kuretake brush pen. Kuretake. Kuretake. And they're amazing pens. You can get them online. I'd show you the image here, but it's in Japanese. So if you can read Japanese, you're in luck. But they're great pens. And then lastly, before I sign off, I'm going to put in some of these spikes here, right? We got in there that mane. And Sienna, these videos will be available online after that. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right. Anyone can watch these anytime.
Correct.
They'll be on our website, lazoo.org, on YouTube, on all our social platforms.
Great. So if you guys, you know, I apologize if I went a little too fast in some areas or too slow, but you will have the chance to review this video and really become a master at drawing the California condor. And I'll monitor those comments as well when I can online. So I can respond back if you guys have questions after the fact, that sort of thing. But I think this pretty much wraps up our first draw along of the California condor.
Thanks so much, Brian. We're getting some fun and funny comments. Thanks to everyone who is watching and drawing along with us. I hope you had fun today drawing the California condor. We would love to see your drawings from today if you want to tag LA Zoo at LA Zoo and at Brian Kesinger. And this is the first in the series of four Saturday draw alongs with so please join us next Saturday for the Mountain Yellow Legged Frog, Saturday the 25th, the Peninsular Pronghorn on Saturday, May 2nd. And the Western Lowland on the final Saturday, May. For more fun LA Zoo content, please visit lazoo.org. And on behalf of Brian Kesinger and all of us at the LA Zoo, thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.